السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا. سبحان ربك رب العزة ما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. Honorable Ulama, my dear brothers and elders, in this very brief session, I want to share with you the love and brotherhood which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam instilled in his companions. The companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam were so special. Allah has talked about them in the previous scriptures. ذَلِكَ مَثَلُهُمْ فِي التَّوْرَاةِ وَمَثَلُهُمْ فِي الْإِنْجِيلِ. In front of Musa alayhi salam and Isa alayhi salam, before the arrival of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً. They were enemies of one another, could not get along with one another. They wanted to kill each other. But when Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was sent here by Allah, and the Prophet looked at them, sat with them, taught them, trained them, purified them, then they became brothers. They became such brothers, whereas before Islam they wanted to kill each other, but after the arrival of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were instilled and bonded in such brotherhood, they wanted to die for each other. And just to give you a glimpse, people say Abu Bakr and Umar were enemies of Ahl Bayt and Ali, na'udhu billah. If Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma had been enemies of Ahl Bayt, and Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu and his family and the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then why would Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu name his children after Abu Bakr and Umar? Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu was blessed by Allah with 14 sons. How many? 14 sons. After one or two, people say, bus, family planning. Enough is enough. Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he didn't have a regular job, no social security, child benefit, no job. But his raziq was Allah. He trusted in Allah. No family planning. Allah blessed him with 14 sons. His first one was Hassan, then Hussein. Then he had two sons, named them Abdullah and Ubaidullah. How many does that make? Four. Three he named after the beloved Prophet of Allah. Muhammad Akbar, Muhammad Awsat, Muhammad Asghar. That makes seven. One he named after his brother, Jafar. Jafar, Yahya, Aun, and then one Abbas. That makes seven and four is 11. How many does that leave? Three. You know what he named them? One he named Abu Bakr, one he named Umar, one he named Uthman. If Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman were enemies of Hazrat Ali, would Hazrat Ali have named his own sons after them? And not only did Hazrat Ali name his children after Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman, Hazrat Hassan, Hazrat Ali's son and the Prophet's grandson, named his own sons Abu Bakr and Umar. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, Hazrat Hassan's son, was with Hazrat Hussein in Karbala when he was martyred. And then Hazrat Hussein also named his sons after Abu Bakr and Umar. So to name your children Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman is the sunnat of Hazrat Ali, sunnat of Hazrat Hassan, and sunnat of Hazrat Hussein. As well as that, Mullah Baqir Majlisi in Hayatul Qulub has written this very clearly and in many times. And if you go on the internet and search in Wikipedia, you will find he is described as the most powerful and influential Shiite scholar of all times. In Hayatul Qulub, he's written that after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, na'uzubillah, all Sahaba left Islam and became Murtad, except Salman Farsi, Miqdad bin Aswad, and Abu Zar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And in some places they make mention of Ammar bin Yasir as well. Na'uzubillah, if that was the case, and we look at how much they loved each other, not only did they name their children after Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman, they also gave and shared their daughters with each other. They gave their daughters in marriage to one another. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu gave his daughter to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as Hafsa. She became the mother of the believers. Please, your attention. Hazrat Umar gave his daughter Hafsa to the Prophet. The Prophet gave his daughter Fatima to Hazrat Ali. Then Hazrat Ali gave his daughter Umme Kulsoom to Hazrat Umar. Hazrat Umar gave it to the Prophet. The Prophet gave it to Hazrat Ali. Hazrat Ali gave to Hazrat Umar, completing the circle. People say Abu Bakr and Hazrat Ali did not get along. One of Hazrat Ali's brothers, Hazrat Jafar, Hazrat Jafar was martyred in the Battle of Muta, leaving behind a widow, Asma bint Umays radiallahu ta'ala anha. When she became a widow, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anha saw that the wife of the brother of Hazrat Ali has become a widow. He proposed, and Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anha accepted, and Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anha married the widow of the brother of Hazrat Ali. The Quran says, وَلَا تَنْكِحُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ حَتَّى يُؤْمِنُوا وَلَا تَنْكِحُ الْمُشْرِكَاتِ حَتَّى يُؤْمِنَّ. Don't marry any mushrika women. Don't marry any mushrik man until they become believers. So if na'udhu billah, in the eyes of Hazrat Ali, Abu Bakr had not been a Muslim and a believer, would Hazrat Ali have allowed his sister-in-law, the widow of his brother, to be married to Abu Bakr? If the daughter of Umar radiallahu ta'ala, Hazrat Hafsa, was not a true believer, would Allah have allowed Hazrat Hafsa to come into the marriage of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And if Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala, na'udhu billah, was not a true believer, would Hazrat Ali himself have given his daughter through Fatima, the granddaughter of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in marriage to Hazrat Umar? Allah knew there will come a time when people will bark, and they will say, open their mouths and insult the blessed and the dear friends of the beloved Prophet of Allah. 1400 years earlier, Allah put this assurance policy in place. If you want to have a look at Umar and even open your mouth against him, think twice. If Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala was none other than a true believer, would Hazrat Ali have given his own daughter to Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu? Would the beloved Prophet of Allah, knowing very well Allah has forbidden him to allow any believing women to be married to non-Muslims, have given not one but two daughters to Usman radiallahu ta'ala anhu? When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave two daughters to Usman, the Prophet confirmed, Allah approved that Usman is a true believer. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam accepting Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha in his marriage, then similarly endorsed, confirmed, approved, sealed the iman of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Let no man open their mouths against those noble souls. If anybody thinks Abu Bakr or Umar or Uthman radiallahu anhu deprived the Ahl Bayt, they did not deprive the Ahl Bayt. They were brothers with the Ahl Bayt. They were guardians of the Ahl Bayt. And they tried to do the best they can for Ahl Bayt. May Allah grant us their love. Love for the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and love for the people the beloved Prophet of Allah loved as well. Wa sallallahu alaihi wasallam ala sayyidina Muhammad.